Good morning, Bethel.
It is
time for Creating with Rabbi Jenny. I'm going to give a few moments for others to catch on and join me. But as I'll say in a minute, I decided this week to do a little bit of creativity in the kitchen, using up some of my chametz and leftover hamantaschen filling. I'm going to give us a few minutes, see if anyone else joins us, and then we'll get started. In the meantime, I'm going to post the link to the recipe that I'm using. Okay, looks like I have a few people join me. Before we get started on any cooking creativity, we of course have to wash our hands. So I'm going to come over and do that for a moment. All right, good morning. So this morning I decided that for creativity, I'm gonna make one of my favorite things to make as a dessert, which is babka. I know some at Bethel discussed maybe we do a babka class in the future. I'm gonna do a quick run through of the stuffing part of it right now. In the comments of the video, I put a link to the recipe that I'm using. I'm really only using the dough recipe from the link that I posted, and I'm gonna do my own filling, because with Passover a week away, I realize I have a little more flour than I need before Passover, and I still have leftover hamantaschen filling. So I'm gonna use both of those and put them to good use to make a delicious dessert that we will have to finish by Tuesday night, which I don't think will be a problem, even just me and my husband in the house. So what we have right here is I made some dough that's already done to the rising point. You can see the recipe for the dough on that link. And I'm gonna uncover it, set aside my clean towel. I'm feeling my dough is nice and kneaded, and I have a rolling, a floured surface, and I'm gonna roll it out into about two times. I'm gonna make two logs, and this is the size pan I'm using, just a regular loaf pan. So I wanna make my, I want a rectangle, and I want to make them as wide as I can so that in a way that will roll into about the width of my pan. Since my dough's been sitting a little bit, it's gonna take a little bit of work to get it rolled out. Oh, I see a comment, but I have to come over and look at it in a moment. I said I'm using leftover hamantaschen filling. So what I will be using is I have some cherry pie filling that I used for making my chocolate cherry hamantaschen. And I have some chocolate chips that are left from other things. The Nestle Toll House allergy sensitive chocolate chips are conveniently parve, because dairy is a common allergen, and therefore I decided to make this particular dough non-dairy so that my dessert will end up, my babka will end up parv, which means that I can have it tomorrow night with Shabbat dinner, even if I decide to have meat. And if anyone has dairy allergies, this will also be a way to have a babka for you as well. Sometimes the one at Trader Joe's, which is, while delicious, is dairy. So here's a way to do a non-dairy one. I'm still rolling, I'm trying to get it nice and thin and into it. There are two ways, if you read through the recipe that I linked, she suggests making two sheets of dough and so making two separate logs that will twist. I'm gonna show another trick that I have seen where you actually make one log and then you cut it open and you get to see all of the beautiful oozy. It gets a little messy, but it's very pretty and it comes out really yummy because you get the moisture of your filling in a few more places around your babka, and then you also don't need to worry about a topping. Almost there on my dough. And other than the dough and the stand mixer, it makes it really easy, but this is a really easy recipe. You can make it with your family, you can do it with adults, kids, anybody can do this one. It's actually not that hard. Often babka seems like one of those really fancy desserts that you don't know how to make and that you only buy the Trader Joe's ones. And I promise it's not that hard. Almost there. My dough is still a little bit oval shaped, not so rectangular, but I'm gonna pull the corners as I need to just to try to get it there. I don't know how well you can see it, but I'll move my stuff aside in a sec. What's my coffee here? I say, good morning, Carrie. Yes, I'm baking for everybody. And somebody in the office has tried my baking before, so. Okay. And my husband's baking. Okay, so now I have my dough. I'm gonna move it aside. You can sort of see it in the frame, but not quite. It's not exactly rectangular. The recipe will say to get it to a rectangle and give you exact measurements, and it's okay. So I have cherry pie filling that I threw into the food processor just to smooth it out a little bit. I only have about a half can here because it's left over from Purim Hamantaschen filling. And as I said, the Nestle Toll House allergen-free chocolate chips are parv. So if you're looking for parv or good, or if you have allergies, these are a good option for your chocolate chips. So I'm doing cherry chocolate chip. So now that I have my dough rolled out, I'm going to put on first the cherry, and I'm going to leave an edge so that it'll all seal back together. I'm going to scoop some on, spread it pretty thin. You can do it all the way to the edge on one side, and on the other side of the longer edge of your rectangle, you're going to want to leave it a little, or on the shorter edge, since I'm doing it the cut way. We're gonna leave it open so that the dough has something to seal up to. Pull this out a little more. So I pre-made the dough. It does need time to rise, just like a bread dough does. Babka is kind of a cross between a bread and a cake. It's a dessert, but it's not quite as quick as just throwing your cake batter together and putting it in the oven. You do want to give your dough some time to rise. And actually this will also need some time to rise after this step that I'm going to show on our video. So I will post pictures later of the completed babka once it comes out of the oven. That'll take a couple hours probably. So I'll need to let it rise again and then I will bake it. I'm using about half a can of cherry pie filling. And then I'm doing chocolate chip. If you want to do a chocolate spread, you do have to melt the chocolate, which is just more complicated than I feel like doing most of the time. So I just like doing a fruit with a little bit of a chocolate chip. Okay, so that's all done. Set these aside. There's no exact measurement for your filling or for your chocolate chips. It's as much as you want. Don't want to overfill because then it'll end up a little too moist. But if you underfill, then you don't get enough moisture. So I don't have an exact measurement, but put a fair amount in without making it too thick. And then sprinkle as many chocolate chips in as you possibly want. Okay. Now I have them. I'll throw a few more in here. Now I have my dough all laid out and I have my filling all laid in. And then here's the fun steps. Rolling and then cutting. So to roll, it's like a jelly roll. Fold your first edge on. Just keep folding and rolling as tight as you can. Your hands will probably get some of the filling on your hands. The various steps of this, but keep going, keep rolling. And then I'd said to leave your edge without any filling on it. That's because you're going to want to, as you get close to the end of the roll, you're going to pick up your last bit of dough and roll it in. Pat it in together, seal up your ends. And some might ooze out a little bit, especially if you like a lot of filling. Okay. So now I could just bake it like this and have a log. But to make it babka, what I'm gonna do, you grab a knife. I'm gonna very gently split most of the log. I'm gonna leave an end unsplit because then I don't have to worry about pinching it back together. But if you end up accidentally or on purpose cutting the whole end, that's okay. But I'm gonna gently cut through my entire log here. And your filling, of course, will ooze out a little bit at this step, which is why this is the messier, but I think prettier option versus doing just two separate logs of filling. So now I have my two split pieces of dough. They're trying to come apart. I'm going to gently turn them filling side up. So I have layers with filling in between. Pulling them up, pulling them up. And now I'm going to twist them together. So I'm going to lift one over the other and just repeat until I'm all the way down. You can go as tight or as loose a twist as you want. And then when you're down at the end, you kind of smush it all back together. Your hands will have your filling on it. I don't know if you can tell from the distance, but I definitely have cherry on my hands right now. And then you pull your loaf pan nearby. And gently lift the whole thing and plop it in to your loaf pan. And at this point, you're gonna have it in your pan. It doesn't look like it fills the pan yet, which is why we have to let it rise for another time. It's gonna sit for about an hour to rise till it looks closer to filling up the loaf pan. And then I will egg wash it and I will bake it for about a half hour. You'll go ahead and refer to the recipe that I posted to look for the exact times and temperatures. Cooks for about a half hour, I think, at 'm looking over the recipe, I printed it ahead of time. It cooks for about a half hour at 350. If you want to do a topping, you can. You could throw more chocolate chips on top once it's out of the second rise phase, but part of why I like cutting it open and twisting it is that the chocolate chips are already somewhat surfacing. So that's a good way to make it. I'm going to enjoy this tomorrow evening with my after Shabbat dinner, and I will post pictures of it later when it's ready to go in the oven and when it comes back out. I hope we all had a good morning, a good day to use up our chametz before Passover comes in a week. A good way to enjoy a dessert. Just rinse off my hands there. I'll wash them again in a minute. But we'll hope you all enjoy getting ready for Passover. both in the preparing for Passover, figuring out when and how you can buy your need things that you need for Passover, and eating up some of your last bit of chametz to make sure that there's room in the kitchen for your Passover things. And we'll see you next week. We'll be doing a Torah talk on Shabbat morning as well as on Passover morning on April 9th. So I look forward to seeing everyone again then. And on Monday night, we will be having a discussion with me and with Rabbi Dennis leading and with Cantor Melissa all about preparing ourselves for Passover and preparing our homes for Passover, especially this year when things are a little bit different. And join us tonight if you would like for a conversation with Ron Klein. I look forward to seeing you at future virtual Bethel events. Have a great day.